linguistic scholars. Today we're going to talk about the cooperative principle of effective communication, also known as Grice's maxims. No, not that kind of maxims. We're talking about Grice's maxims of effective and clear communication. Grice's maxims are observations and descriptions of how effective communication in conversation is achieved in common social situations. The idea is that listeners and speakers must act cooperatively to be understood in any particular way. The idea is that both parties assume collaboration and have respect for mutual knowledge, and the idea presumes that there will be some unspoken mutual understandings. Paul Grice, who Grice's maxims are named after, said, "Make your contribution such as it is required, at the stage at which it occurs, by the accepted purpose or direction of the talk exchange in which you are engaged." But a textbook definition can be confusing. So let's take a look at the four maxims, and then we'll look at some examples, and hopefully that'll give us a better understanding. The first maxim is the maxim of quantity. We also have the maxim of quality. Next, we have the maxim of relation or relevance. And lastly, we have the maxim of manner. So to better understand these maxims, we'll take a look at some examples, but perhaps rather than watching them in place, seeing what is being said through the misuse could be a better way to understand them.
Now that's a lot of S's. S. S. Moltar, I think there's something wrong with my sibilance. 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 Sibilance.
But perhaps misuse is the wrong word when describing a divergence from standard use of the maxims. In fact, it's quite common in normal conversation, and the terms we use to describe this are flouting and violating. Flouting is to not follow Grice's maxims with the intent to convey an alternate meaning, like when we use sarcasm. The listener is intended to comprehend the mutual understanding. However, when violating the maxims, what we mean is to not follow them, often unintentionally, and this can cause communicative difficulty for both of the interlocutors. Now we'll take a look at each of Grice's maxims one by one to give us a better understanding of how they work. First, we have the maxim of quantity. This is, make your contribution as informative as is required. Do not make your contribution more informative than is required. Let us watch Mojo Jojo now give more information than is required, thus violating the maxim of quantity.
So, Mojo, is that your final answer?
Is that my final answer?
Yes, that is the question, isn't it? Whether this answer that I am thinking about choosing is the one that I will say is the final one. Which is to say that you have asked me a question about this answer being the one that I will ultimately pick as the response that I am sure of, for it is the one that I have deliberated on.
You do have one lifeline left, Mojo Jojo. Would you like to use it?
Mojo must think about this. For if I use this lifeline, that is my last, then I will have no more lifelines. And that will mean that in the future when I might want to use this lifeline, that it will no longer be available to me, as I will already have used it now when you ask me if I wanted to choose to use a lifeline.
Perhaps someone you'd like to call.
Call? Yes, call! I could call someone on the telephone, and it would ring at the house, and they would pick it up. And then I would ask them the answer to this question that I am thinking about and unable to answer on my own, despite my superior intellect.
See, this is why I'd rather watch Price is Right.
Next, we have the maxim of quality. Say what is true, and do not say that which you believe to be false. It is also important that you do not say that for which you lack adequate evidence. Let us now look at a violation of the maxim of quality.
It's a shame Abu had to miss this.
Nah, he hates fireworks. He doesn't really like flying either. That is, oh no.
You are the boy from the market. I knew it. Why did you lie to me?
Jasmine, I'm sorry.
Did you think I was stupid?
No.
That I wouldn't figure it out?
No, I hoped you wouldn't. No, that's not what I meant.
Who are you? Tell me the truth.
The truth? The truth? The truth is, I sometimes dress as a commoner, to escape the pressures of palace life.
Next we have the maxim of relation. This one's pretty straightforward. Be relevant!
How did you deal with the mobs?
Yeah, it does get pretty crazy in the summer. But, you know, you just gotta roll.
He just rolls. That's cool that he rolls.
That guy was all over the place. Anyway, lastly we have the maxim of manner. Be clear. Avoid obscurity of expression. Be brief. Be orderly. And above all, avoid ambiguity.
Take this crystal, Gary. It holds all the secrets.
Thrust it, Gary! Not so fast, you two.
I've disabled their control panel.
Good work, Gary.
Where's the entrance, Ace?
Let's just stick it right through the dumpster, Gary.
Work it, Ace!
Those villains! They're trying to probe our most sensitive areas. I can feel it.
Grab the plug by the male end and stick it in the hole.
Ha! Their freeze ray couldn't withstand the heat of your warm, young flesh.
Commissioner, we make a great team. You finger the perps, and we give them our fists. Now who's being penetrated without expecting it?
Looks all right to me. Check yourself.
All right. Looks good from here, Gary.
See ya, kids!
Now what's everybody looking at?
Nothing!
Ace and Gary!
I hear they're fruits.
Now that we have seen some examples, let us have a quick recap. We have the maxim of quantity. Make your contribution as informative as is required. Not too much information. The maxim of quality. Make your contribution one that is true. Do not say that which is false, and do not say that for which you lack adequate evidence. The maxim of relation. Be relevant! And lastly, what we just saw, the maxim of manner. Be clear, avoid obscurity, avoid ambiguity, be brief, and be orderly. Far more can be said about Grice's maxims, but this is going to do it for today's brief introduction. Thanks for watching, and now Zorak to send us off to commercial.
Sometimes I feel like I was executed for my crimes against the universe. And this talk show is my eternal torment.
All against me. They're all against me.